Armorer Bryan Carpenter and legal analyst Gregg Jarrett discusses gun safety in light of Alec Baldwin allegedly firing a gun on set, which killed cinematographer Helena Hutchins. On Hannity, Rust assistant director Dave Halls has maintained Alec Baldwin's claim that he didn't pull the trigger of the gun that fired and left cinematographer Helena Hutchins dead and director Joel Souza injured, his attorney says. Lisa Tarako, who is representing Halls, said in a new interview that the assistant director has said from the first day she met him that he believes a misfire took place. The entire time Baldwin had his finger outside the trigger guard, parallel to the barrel, and that he told me since day one he thought it was a misfire. And until Alec said that it was just really hard to believe. But Dave has told me since the first day I met him that Alec did not pull that trigger, Tarako said in an interview that aired on Good Morning America on Thursday. Seth Kenny was also interviewed. He is the owner of PDQ Arm and Prop LLC, which provided guns and ammunition to the production of Rust. He said he's absolutely certain PDQ Arm and Prop did not accidentally send live rounds to the movie set. Alec Baldwin's claim he didn't pull trigger on Rust questioned by Sheriff, guns don't just go off. Alec Baldwin claimed he did not pull the trigger during a preview for an upcoming tell-all interview regarding the fatal shooting on the set of Rust. Photo by OGUT/StarMax/GC Images, it's not a possibility that they came from PDQ or from myself personally. When we send dummy rounds out, they get individually rattle tested before they get sent out. So if you have a box of 50, you've got to do it 50 times, and then at that point you know they're safe to sound, he said. Kenny also claimed the live ammunition that was seized doesn't match what was on set. He also provided the outlet invoices showing the purchases made by Rust, the report said. The outlet reports at PDQ wasn't their only provider. They found four rounds that were close enough to take in with them. They're not a match, but they were close, so there's something very unique about the live rounds that were found on Rust, but we've got to wait for the FBI to do its job. Alec Baldwin says he did not pull the trigger in fatal Rust shooting incident. Would never. It was announced on Wednesday that Baldwin will sit down for his first formal interview about the fatal shooting that took place on the set of the indie western film Rust. In a preview for the tell-all, Baldwin addresses the fact that he was holding a gun that was somehow loaded with a live bullet that should not have been on the set at all, let alone in an actor's hand. An aerial view of the film set on Bonanza Creek Ranch, where Hollywood actor Alec Baldwin fatally shot cinematographer Helena Hutchins, Reuters, during the preview, which is heavily edited for the purpose of teasing the larger interview that's set to air Thursday evening. An emotional Baldwin states unequivocally that he did not pull the trigger. The trigger wasn't pulled. I didn't pull the trigger, Baldwin told George Stephanopoulos. He adds, no, 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 I would never point a gun at anyone and pull the trigger. Never. Click here to sign up for the entertainment newsletter. However, the Santa Fe County Sheriff's Department said in a warrant that Baldwin fired the gun. Baldwin was holding the gun and rehearsing a scene for the movie, and a live round rang out, hitting Hutchins before getting stuck in the shoulder of director Joel Souza. The Santa Fe Sheriff's Department said it is awaiting results from the FBI, which would shed light on how the gun could have been fired. Whether that was just pulling back the hammer, which hits the firing pin, just pulling the trigger, or both. The Santa Fe Sheriff's Department said it is awaiting results from the FBI, which would shed light on how the gun could have been fired, whether that was just pulling back the hammer, which hits the firing pin, just pulling the trigger, or both. Jim Spellman, /Getty Images, guns don't just go off, Sheriff Adon Mendoza told Fox News Digital. So whatever needs to happen to manipulate the firearm, he did that and it was in his hands. The fourth search warrant released by the Santa Fe Sheriff's Department shows armorer Hannah Gutierrez Reed suggested someone on the set had potentially pulled the hammer back on the .45 Colt revolver during her interviews with police. Click here to get the Fox News app. We had the gun the whole time before that and nothing happened. And I wasn't in there, and they weren't even supposed to be pulling the hammer back, Gutierrez Reed was quoted saying in the search warrant. Fox News' Lauren Overholtz and Tyler McCarthy contributed to this report.